Hi everyone, my name is Daryl and welcome back to another Gran Turismo 7 video. In today's video, we are doing a tune of one of the three legendary cars in GT7 for the Le Mans trophy achievement. Last week, the Ford Mark IV was available in the legendary car shop, so I got to purchase it and tune it fittingly for the Le Mans race. This is my first car of the three that are needed for the Le Mans trophy achievement, with the other two being the Ferrari 330 P4 and the Jaguar XJ13. The Ford Mark IV won the Le Mans 24-hour race against those two cars in 1967, so it's very fitting that this is the car that I am choosing to tune for this circuit. Being an older car, the handling of the Mark IV is surprisingly light and agile. It also has good acceleration and top speed for the long straights of the Le Mans circuit. The tune that we will be doing today will utilize the top speed and also the handling of this car to get easy wins in the 700 PP race. Before we get into the video, if you're new to the channel or have not subscribed yet, please click on that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of our future GT7 videos. And if you like this tuning content, click on the like button and leave a comment on what you think about this tune, or if you have any requests for future tunes to be featured in this channel. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this car and what you race with in GT7. So let's go to the tuning shop and see the parts that we need for this car. The most important one will always be the racing intermediate tires, as it always rains in the Le Mans or the Sarthe circuit. So the next things that we need are the racing intercooler, the racing muffler, and you also need the brakes, the fully customizable suspension and transmission, the brake controller, and the racing hard tires. We also purchased the crankshaft, the low-end supercharger, as well as the customizable LSD. We also need to purchase the power restrictor and the ballast for this build. For the tuning, this is a racing hard tire build. The first thing you do is to adjust the body height to 125 for the front. Then go to your transmission and select racing transmission. I will not be using the supercharger for this one, but you may opt to just add a little more ballast. What I will do with the ballast here is set it to 99 and the position is negative 50. You just have to dial in the ballast to get around the 700 PP range. And then lastly, I set my top speed to 300 or 290. Either way, this will be a fast build. You can set the auto top speed to your liking, depending on if you want more acceleration or more top speed. So for the race strategy, the first thing that we will do is change our fuel mapping to 6. That is the most important part of this build, so that you will last a lot longer. And this will be a 2 pit stop strategy. Whether it rains or it doesn't, you will need to stop twice like the other cars to get through to the 6 laps that you need for the 30 minutes. Even at fuel map 6, this car has plenty of speed to overtake the other car, so take your time and be careful with your overtaking so that you don't get penalties. Once you get to the straights, it will be all out and you will be overtaking all the other cars as you have superior acceleration and top speed in the Mark 4. Also, it's a good practice in lap 1 to get into the slipstream of your opponents before doing a slingshot, but try to do it before the turn. This one, I was really close to the turn when I did the slingshot. So also just be careful of the oversteer, or sometimes this car skids, especially when it's wet. So just watch out for those things when driving, especially in this long straights with those S-turns. So as you can see, it started to rain at lap 2 by the end of the lap, so I already decided to get into the pits for both tire change and also for fuel. This way I can get a head start on the opponents with the right strategy. After all, the Le Mans 24-hour race is mostly about your fuel and pit strategies. If you get your fuel and pit strategies right, you will most definitely win this race. I just don't like the pit entry here, and I oftentimes slow down a lot for the pit entry. So what I did was change to racing intermediates and fueled up to the maximum so that I can get to at least lap 5 on a full tank of fuel. It is also very important to pit ahead of everybody else during this time, because the AI will also still be in their racing hards or racing soft tires, and they will have a harder time racing in wet conditions, especially if it rains hard. There are times that it rains for 2 laps or 3 laps, but I've experienced that sometimes it rains for the until lap 6 or 7. So when getting out of the pits, just be careful, since you have cold tires and also a full tank of fuel, so it will be a little shaky at the start, but once your tires get up into temp, you will be lapping as usual. So the second pit stop that I had was at the end of lap 5. This is mainly because I was running out of fuel already. My tires still look good. But while you are at it, you might want to just change the tires along with a full tank of fuel. But you can also see that I have a 1 minute advantage over the other cars, as they were struggling in laps 3 and 4 when they did not get into the pits when it rained. So that's where your advantage lies in this race. The other cars will also be pitting at this time, so there you will not be worried about losing time during this pit stop or be overtaken by the other cars. So fast forward to the end of lap 6, as you can see, the timer has only 30 seconds left, and I will just be completing 6 laps with this car for this race. Normally, if you cross the line before the timer expires, you will be required to do another lap in the race, but you will finish in first. So luckily, with this race, in the two-stop strategy, exactly 6 laps would be needed to complete it in the Ford Mark IV. So I guess that's it for this tuning strategy for the Ford Mark IV. I hope you give this tune a try, and do let me know in the comments below what you think of this car and how it feels here in the Le Mans 700 PP race. So my next video will be a video on the BMW McLaren F1 race car and also a build for the RX-7 in the Sardinia 800 PP race. So if you have not subscribed yet, please click on that subscribe button so you don't miss out on those videos. And before anything else, thank you for hanging out with me in this video. Once again, my name is Daryl, and I will see you in my next video. Happy racing!